take in scorn. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy.
Thank you. We gather this evening to celebrate the incarnation of the Word of God in human flesh as Emmanuel, the Prince of Peace, the light of the world. As we remember the birth of Jesus 2,000 years ago in a distant land, I want to call our minds to the history of this land, right here, where we gather, a land that the descendants of its first inhabitants call Turtle Island. This land has been inhabited and cared for with deep love and respect by various peoples since time immemorial, which is long before Jesus was born. Most recently, the land we're on has been the traditional territory of the Anishinaabeg, the Haudenosaunee, and the Chonanton. Many non-Indigenous people living on the land have acted as if these Indigenous people have disappeared. But now we see Indigenous people here, and we are listening with respect to their stories, to their spirituality, as told in their own words. We are people of the new covenant with God, and in Canada, we're all treaty people. Therefore, we seek out ways to live in accord with the treaties that were made. We seek to live in ways that support renewed structures that include Indigenous people in fully sharing this land and her riches. Tonight, we remember the birth of Jesus, the light of the world. Tonight, we remember the call to live faithfully in our covenant with God, who is the faithful one. And we remember our responsibility to live faithfully in all covenants that we are a part of, including treaties made with Indigenous peoples.
Well, welcome and Merry Christmas evening to all of you. Welcome to our Waterloo North Mennonite Church Candlelight Christmas Eve service. Welcome to those present this evening who traveled through a winter wonderland, and welcome to those who are viewing our live stream. I want to thank those who presented our prelude. You have prepared us well. Thank you. If you don't have a handheld candle for yourself, which we'll be using it later on in the service, we have some in the back just to go back there during a hymn, a song, and pick one up. There's also an offering basket to the rear of the sanctuary, and our children and junior youth have designated the recipients of this evening's offering to be the Waterloo Region Food Bank and Community Peacemaker teams. You can also do an e-transfer, and that goes to finance@waterloonorthmc.org. So you can pull out your phones right now and do that transfer. We'll wait a minute or two. That's finance@waterloonorthmc.org. And anything that sent in the next hour will go to our Christmas Eve designated offering. And when you're finished, please mute your phone and put it away. We'll begin our service with Psalm 27:14. Wait for the Lord. Be strong and let your heart take courage. Wait for the Lord.
Please join me in the reading of the litany for the lighting of the first candle on the screen or in your bulletin. Yours is the blueprint. Watch. The time is drawing near. Now is the moment for you to wake from sleep. The night is far gone. The day is near. As we watch, we light this candle as a sign of our hope.
Barely midnight, all of us hunkered down around the ashes of a fire. The animals asleep, our companions, hunger, nagging doubt. Our wants are reasonable. Provisions for the family, better health, a better bed than this hard slope, good grazing, sturdy lambs, and death to predators whose hostile howls invade our restless dreams. But let's be honest. Let's admit right now, what we want most is foolproof evidence that God exists and knows we're here. We want our sorrows noted, our frantic labors recognized. We want the Holy One, although it's dark and late the hour, to hunker with us here at the fire's glow and speak with us right here, right now.
In the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be lifted up, and every mountain and hill be made low. The uneven ground shall become level, and the rough places a plain. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken.
Hear this vision, this dream from the prophet Isaiah. A shoot shall come out from the stump of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. His delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by what his eyes see or decide by what his ears hear, but with righteousness he shall judge for the poor and decide with equity for the oppressed of the earth. He shall strike the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall kill the wicked. Righteousness shall be the belt around his waist, and faithfulness the belt around his loins. The wolf shall live with the lamb. The leopard shall lie down with the kid. The calf and the lion will feed together, and a little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze. Their young shall lie down together. The lion shall eat straw like the ox. The nursing child shall play over the hole of the asp, and the weaned child shall put its hand on the otter's den. They will not hurt or destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth will be full of the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea. On that day, the root of Jesse shall stand as a signal to the peoples. The nations shall inquire of him, and his dwelling shall be glorious. Please join with me in the litany for the second candle. John the Baptist proclaimed, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven has come near.
Prepare the way of the Lord. Make God's path straight."
As we prepare, we light this candle as a sign of peace.
Bring your restoration.
People who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Great will be his authority, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. Join me now in the litany as we light the third candle. Strengthen our hearts, for the coming of the Lord is soon. As we gather strength, we light this candle as a sign of your love made visible among us.
Bring your restoration to your people, we
Then Isaiah said, "Hear then, O house of David, is it too little for you to weary mortals that you weary God also? Therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. Look, the young woman is with child and shall bear a son, and he shall be named Emmanuel." In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overtake it. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood or of the will of the flesh or of the will of people, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory and the glory of a parent's only child, full of grace and truth. Please join me for the litany for the fourth candle of Advent. We cry out for restoration. We call upon God to give us life. As we hold fast to God's promise, we light this candle as a sign of our joy.
with the choir from time to time, even though you're not getting a lot of cues. And I'm very grateful for the descant we heard earlier and hope that might come in again later. And even for two verses or more would be lovely. And at this point, I want to say that we are making some adjustments. And I'm thanking Hesse for singing the solo that Kim Ens Hildebrandt was prepared from singing because of the weather. So this was all decided just about 5:30. And thank you for following along so well, even though most of the program, especially our singing, is unannounced. Okay, I think the instrumentalists now are together, and let's sing Still, 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 2-6-4. And please stand.
The Gospel of Luke tells of the birth of Jesus like this. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descendant from the house and the family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in the manger, because there was no place in the guest room. Now in that same region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks at night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. For see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. you will find a child wrapped in the bands of cloth and lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with an angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest heaven and on earth, peace to all whom God favors.
Continuing with the story from Luke. When the angels had returned to heaven, the shepherds said to each other, "Let's go to Bethlehem. Let's see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." They hurried to the village and found Mary and Joseph, and there was the baby lying in the manger. After seeing him, the shepherds told everyone what had happened and what the angel had said to them about this child. And all who heard the shepherd's story were astonished. But Mary kept all these things in her heart and thought about them often. The shepherds went back to their flocks, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen. It was just as the angel had said to them. And now I invite you to join in the litany for the lighting of the Christ candle. God comes with hope, joy, peace, and love for the entire world.
Emmanuel, God is with us.
Jesus is God's gift of self-revelation. Let us be illuminated by God's light.
Glory to God.
We would invite you to sing Silent Night. It follows just before the choir has finished singing Night of Silence. Then you're going to come in with the tenors and baritones from the choir on verse 1 and continue on unaccompanied. So I'll cue you from the choir side of the room. But I think first we'll sing What Child Is This? Thanks, Anita. If it's safe to stand, please do.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Every time we have had a handheld candlelight service, I'm amazed we don't burn the church down, but thanks for doing a wonderful job. When you leave, please return your candle to the gray bins as you go out. And would you bow for the benediction? Breathe deeply. Hear the angels sing. God is with us. God is with us. Glory to God. Peace on earth. Go in peace. Amen. Merry Christmas and joy to the world.